Good afternoon. Thank you all so much for attending our fall concert today. My name is Kristen Beeman, and I'm the executive director for the Longmont Youth Symphony. We are so glad that you decided to join us. This should be a wonderful afternoon of music. I would like to take a moment to thank our season sponsors, SCFD, the Scientific, Cultural, and Facilities District, the Longmont Community Foundation, Qualcomm, and King Supers. We are still looking for concert and season sponsors for the remainder of this season. So if you are interested, if you have a business who is interested in supporting LYS in any capacity, please let us know. We would love to advertise your business in our beautiful programs. And I'm happy to provide more information on how to do that. We are also still in need of a sponsor for our finale gala concert. So if you are interested in sponsoring that event, please let me know, and I'll be happy to provide more information about that. I also want to invite everyone to participate in our King Supers fundraiser. Be sure, it's a new program this year, so it used to be that we had these little cards that you'd have to reload every time you wanted to buy groceries. That's not the process anymore. So be sure that you have linked LYS to your King Supers account. There's more information in the newsletter that I send out about how to do that, and I'm also happy to provide information at any of our Saturday rehearsals. Thanks to your support, last season we brought in over $2,500 thanks to this program, so this is a wonderful opportunity for growth for our organization. And again, it's something that everybody does. We all buy groceries and we all buy gas, so help support LYS and make your money go further by supporting us. I'd also like to remind you all about the Amazon Smile program. Every time that you shop on Amazon, as long as you've linked LYS to your Amazon account using smile.amazon.com, a portion of your purchases go directly back to LYS with that as well. And again, both of these are wonderful fundraisers because you don't have to spend any extra money. You don't have to do anything other than what you're already doing. Just make sure you've linked LYS with King Supers and with smile.amazon.com. Also, would like to let you all know that our next upcoming event is our winter concert on November 24th. So we'd like to invite you all to come back and attend that concert as well. It will also be here at Longmont High School. And finally, don't forget, we have the Colorado Gives Day is coming up on Tuesday, December 10th. This is a wonderful opportunity to raise awareness for our wonderful youth symphony. So please give during the Colorado Gives Day. It's a wonderful, wonderful opportunity. So now I'd like to welcome the Longmont Youth Strings Ensemble to the stage under the direction of Robert Staley.
Thank you so much for joining us today. Again, my name is Robert Staley, and we are the String Ensemble. Really looking forward to sharing the music that we've been working on with you today. First up is Fantasia on an original theme. And Fantasia is a word that we see a lot, even if it's only that we've seen it from either of the Fantasia movies. But a Fantasia is kind of like the word fantasy. So it's these different imaginations of possibilities of a melody. So you'll hear a melody at the beginning from our lovely viola section, and then we'll hear kind of different combinations of that. We've been using this piece to really work on get a good quality of sound and work on our bow control this year. Please enjoy Fantasia on the original theme.
Thank you.
All right, our next tune is called Agincourt, and by contrast, this is going to be a much more fighting, fast, exciting kind of piece. The composer tells us, inspired by the climactic battle scene in Shakespeare's Henry V, Agincourt is a fiery, rhythmic piece in 7/8 time. So we also had to learn how to count to 7. Usually musicians just learn to count to 4 and then they give up, but we had to learn a couple extra numbers. Advanced orchestra, Agincourt is exhilarating, dramatic, and from its brash opening to its brazen end. So please enjoy Agincourt. As I'm sure you can tell, they've been an absolute joy to work with so far this year. They've come to rehearsal every day, excited for the music and making a lot of progress. And so thank you all for the work that you put in this year. Thank you all so much to the parents who have been encouraging practicing and getting students to rehearsal. We appreciate it so much. And thank you to all the private teachers that we had out in the audience. And thank you, parents, for getting them to private lessons and everything. Thanks to all of you. Can we have a round of applause for all of our parents and teachers? For our final selection today, we have Spirit of Colorado, and this is by Susan Day. And Susan Day is a Colorado composer. She lives down in the Denver area. So this piece is going to try and set up a couple different scenes about Colorado, and it is very inspired by Colorado's history. So we'll start out with an Indian theme, followed by a cowboy theme, and a railroad theme. I think all of those would be really evident to you. Then the piece will slow down a little bit, and you'll hear a majestic mountain section. It's really not hard to imagine a sunrise over Red Rocks during that section. Please enjoy Spirit of Colorado.
Thank you. How about one more round of applause for the strings ensemble? My name is John King. For those of you who don't know me, I'm the president of the board of directors for Longmont Youth Symphony. I'd like to reiterate some of the statements Robert made. We really appreciate all of our families who share their students and their talents with our organization. Obviously, this organization is nothing without the students, and we know that along with the hard work that the students put in, there's certainly lots of effort and lots of efforts that the families have to put in to get them to rehearsals, get them to concerts, and so on. So we really appreciate everybody's support of the Longmont Youth Symphony. At this time, I'd like to welcome Sarah Modio to the stage. Sarah is a longtime Longmont Youth Symphony parent and board member. She's also very active in a group called LPI, the Longmont Performing Arts Initiative. And so we've asked her here today to give an update on things that LPI are up to. So, Sarah Modio.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you, John, and thank you for your leadership on the LYS board. As everyone's getting set up here, I just wanted to extend a very warm welcome before I kind of go into some of the LYS stuff. A very warm welcome to the new families that we have here in LYS. And if you're a new family, if you could just raise your hand. We want to extend a very, very warm welcome and invite you to become more active in the OIS family. And we just are so pleased that you have chosen OIS as an opportunity to see some development musically in your children. We've been, as John mentioned, we've been a family here in OIS for the past 6 years, and we've seen such tremendous growth and maturity in our daughter's music phase. So it's been a real joy. As John mentioned, I am the liaison for LYS to LPI, and LPI is the Longmont Performing Arts Initiative. It is a group of six organizations that have come together. They came together about 2 years ago to promote the performing arts community and to join forces to explore how we can potentially build a state-of-the-art performing arts center here in Longmont, kind of akin to the Denver Performing Arts Center or the Armada Center. We see this as a wonderful opportunity. We have a lively performing arts community here in Longmont, and we just invite you to check out their website to learn more. We have an upcoming fundraiser on the 25th that we're inviting all of you to attend. The website that I'm inviting you to check out is www.longmontperforms.org. And the upcoming fundraiser that we have is a jazz orchestra night and dance night. And it's at the Fox Hill Club. It promises to be a very fun, exciting evening and full of dancing and a lot of fun. So please, please, please check out the website, Longmont Performing Arts Center, the Longmont Performing Arts Initiative, and that's longmontperforms.org. And without further ado, we would like to bring on the Wind Ensemble. So thank you very much.
We're just going to be right to playing some music for you. Thank you. new, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tony Kading, and I'm new to this ensemble. Many of these students have been doing this and with this ensemble for a while, but this is my first concert, and I just have to say thank you for so many reasons. Thank you. Thank you for representing these students, for taking them to all the places that they need to be, all the lessons that they need to be, to everything that you do to support them. I greatly appreciate it for so many reasons, and for one of those reasons is these sorts of moments that we can make beautiful music together. That last piece of music was a hymn song of Philip Bliss. I didn't know these students when I first started working with this ensemble. I didn't know what to expect. I had some ideas, I heard some things, some great things, but I didn't know what to expect. And when you're choosing music that you're going to make with some people that you don't know, it's kind of difficult. So I went with an idea that some people use to give luck at the beginning of a new journey. Something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue. The first piece of music was written by Percy Grainger, and I believe it was 1918, is that what we discovered? 1918, he collected the folk song in 1906, but he wrote it in 1918, so there's our something old. Something new, that second piece we played was Shine by Michael Markowski, which was written within the past 10 years, I believe, and is about an alien abduction. We can talk more about that later if needed. but it was a fun piece for us to dig into a little bit. The most recent piece we played was Hymn Song of Philip Bliss, which was an amazing and powerful story of a businessman from Chicago in the late 1800s, sent his family off on a vacation. He was supposed to go with them, but something about business kept him back, and they traveled across the Atlantic Ocean, and unfortunately, there was a major catastrophe, and he got a message, a wire from his wife that said, saved alone. His wife was the only one of his family that went, that survived. They had four daughters also on that voyage, and they didn't make it. And so he wrote, trying to understand his emotions with everything, he wrote some lines of some poetry that eventually turned into a hymn that David Holsinger then borrowed that hymn and made this piece of music on. And so that's the Something Borrowed. And our last piece is the Blue Orchid Tango for our Something Blue. And thank you again so much for all of your support for these students and for music in your schools. It's very extremely important, and I know that I'm preaching to the choir here, but thank you.